Welcome to the CHC Wrap Up Show. This week we're coming to you from the Arbuckle Mountain Futurity in Ardmore, Oklahoma, bringing you all the results from the Open and Non-Pro divisions so far. And what a show it's been. It's been a huge turnout here. Over $100,000 added in the four-year-old Open alone, along with some new limited divisions here that include a $200,000 rollback. So any rider that hadn't won over $200,000 in the last 2 years was eligible for the limited, which was a separate class. So a combination of things drew a lot of extra entries here. And I'll tell you what, we've had some long days here this week, but there's been a lot of exciting cutting. So we're going to get right into it with the four-year-old Open. And like I said, the total purse in that one ended up being $218,550. We had 123 entries in the first go round, 75 of those advanced to the second go round, and then 26 to the finals. And in the finals, it was a champion, Austin Shepherd, with a 228.5 on Kinky Boots, owned by Glenn and Debbie Drake. They collected the champion's check for $30,000. So this is one of the bigger paying four-year-olds that that we have here, you know, throughout the year. Austin had two total finalists and won just over $32,000 total, so he had a pretty good show here with that. The reserve champion, Mr. Adan Banuelos, he showed up with a trailer full and he marked a 226.5 on Twice in Santiago, owned by Double Dove Ranch, and they collected the reserve champion's check for $25,000, so pretty good payday for them. The other exciting news for them is that with this reserve championship, it's moved them up into the top place for the Open Horse of the Year standings. CHC's keeping standings on all the hottie points for the Open and Non-Pro again this year. And with that win, that puts Adan ahead by 48 points over the 2019 Futurity champion, Metallic Ray Mink, that was shown by Gary Belafonte. So congratulations to that team. In the gelding division, Kenny Platt scored a 222.5 on Dr. Suish, owned by Robert Tregemba. They collected the champion's check in that division for just over $3,073. And in the novice, the champion with a 224.5 was Counting Hot Checks, owned by Jamie Hill, shown by Jamie Snyder. Champion's check in that one, $5,252.80. And then in the limited, the champion was Blue Laney Bird, owned by EE Ranches, shown by Guy Woods, collecting just over $6,000, including some bonuses there. And the reserve champion in the limited four-year-old was Paradox Blu-ray with a 221, shown by Nick O'Dell, and owned by Mike and Sue Christensen. They collected a check for $4,000. And the 5-6-year-old Open here at the Arbuckle Mountain Futurity had 10,000 added for a total purse of $45,064 in the Open. And there were 74 total entries in there. It took a 221 to advance to the finals with 20 horses advancing. It was one of the toughest cuttings we've seen, taking, like I said, the 221 to advance. It was almost like a one-go-round Mercuria finals. I mean, they were going for it, and it showed. The champion in that event in the finals was the first horse out, Metallic's MVP, ridden by Bo Gallion, owned by Billy Wolf, scoring a 228 for the win. They won $7,500 plus an additional $5,000 bonus from the Faith Mountain Ranch, so that was pretty good for them. They were also the novice champions here. The novice here, as many of you have seen here in recent shows, the novice counts weekend money only. And because most of these horses haven't shown on weekends, some of these high, you know, earning horses and big time horses are eligible for it. But they won another $2,940 in that one. So this team, you might remember them, they were also the Abilene Spectacular champions earlier this year, where they also drew first in the finals. So they seem to like that hole and have done pretty well from there. The reserve champion in that division was Rolls-Royce, again with Bo Gallion in the saddle, 224.5. That stallion is owned by Thomas Gwynn and they collected $6,000 for the reserve champion's check. In the 5-6-year-old, the gelding champion was Special New Boone, ridden by Super Cooper, Michael Cooper, 222, winning $2,116.80. So congratulations to them. The 5-6-year-old limited division was another big class with 45 entries, a total purse of $17,909. It took 11 horses to the finals in that one, and the champion was Mr. Jody Gallion with a 223 on Desiresome Metallic, owned by Atwood Quarter Horses. They won $3,677 for the win, plus an additional $2,500 bonus check from the Faith Mountain Ranch. The reserve champion in that one was Mr. Clay Johnson with a 218.5 on I'm a Ray Cat, owned by William and Billy Aylesworth. They won $3,142. So congratulations to those guys. And we just wrapped up all the non-pro finals here, and in the four-year-old non-pro, there were 47 entries. It took a 213 and a half to make the finals in that one. And we had co-champions, both scoring 222s. Julie Jarma on Metallic Bonus, and Lance Cooper on Whiskey Makes Me Frisky. Like I said, they split the championship in that one, each earning $11,682 for the win there. These two teams also split the gelding and the novice, so they collect some extra money there as well. And the champion of the limited division was Chelsea Tatum on Stevia in that one. In the 5-6 non-pro, it was John Johnson. He scored a 228 on Miss Masterson, and also was the limited champion in that division. Had a magnificent run. Crowd was going nuts for that one, giving him a big standing ovation as he was walking out of the arena. He won just over $5,000 in that division. We had co-reserve champions, both scoring 222s. Kelsey Johnson aboard Smart Cat Ray RG, and Jessica Gonzalez on Mean Bean. They both earned $3,618 in that one. So that wraps up all the open and non-pro divisions here. We'll have all the amateur champions tomorrow here, and then we'll be headed straight to Graham, Texas from here for the Cattlemen's Derby and Classic. So stay tuned for all the amateur champions results on our Facebook page or on our website. You can follow everything there. And don't forget, CHC Live Scoring is where you can keep up with all the action. Thank you so much to June McGee, Scott Chartier over at Justin Insurance for allowing us to bring you this wrap-up show from the Arbuckle Mountain Futurity. We'll see you at the next one. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel right here and receive notifications for all the latest videos we post here. And follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, and we'll keep you updated on everything that's going on in the cutting arena near you. Thanks for watching.